do that.
Is your impression that the word profit is a bad word? I'm not quite...
Yes, sure. It is, sir. Terrible word. Yeah, he doesn't like it. Terrible. It's worse than any kind of profanity.
What'd you say?
It's a kind of profanity.
I'm a disabled veteran, and a veteran of World War I and World War II, and I've saved a little money over the years and put that money into things like Eastman Kodak, General Electric, things, stocks of that nature. Is that a bad thing to do?
Yes, it is.
What do you think?
Yes, it is. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Because you're living off the backs of other people. All kinds of investments. Other people carry you. There are a hell of a lot of people in America that invest thousands of dollars in different corporations, but it's the working force in that plant that's carrying them.
Well, aren't they paid?
Yeah, but other people are paid for years for an investment they made at one time.
I don't quite understand.
I know that,
but perhaps I'm simple-minded and don't...
Well, sir, if I have to carry bags of oranges for 20 years to help pay Larry King that once invested $3,000 in the beginning of an orange grove, I am carrying Larry King and his family the rest of my life. That's what I mean. If you mean by wrong, if you earn your living by the sweat of your brow, do you know whose brow? In other words, when you run a motion picture continuously on television and the studios make a lot of money, if the actors don't get paid for pictures they worked in 10 years ago, the studio does. I consider that living on their talents or back.
Well, that may well be. You may be right about that.
Well, I think you'd like the system I'm talking about, because there's no fall guy.
Uh-huh.
They bring you up to think that somebody's got to be on the bottom,
years,
on the totem pole.
And was able to save a little money, aside from taxes.
Well, under his concept, which appears to me idealistic,
yes,
you wouldn't have had to work 45 years,
right,
and you wouldn't have
exactly
had to worry about saving money.
So within the present system, I think you're following the rules of the game, which I think is appropriate at this time. You have no choice. I'm not telling you to give your money to the poor. I'm just suggesting that you think about the future differently and go right on as you must in this culture, because the rules of the game of this culture are another way.
Now, was it a bad thing for me to go into the Army, volunteer in World War I, and take $30 a month, 15 of which I sent home to my mother?
I don't think it was a bad thing, sir. I think that all of us are victims of a given system. I think that the manipulators of the system are sick people, in the sense that they are uneducated. They don't know how else to solve a problem. And I would not sacrifice any American life for any differences of political view. But I think we can resolve the differences because we've got brains. And when we cannot resolve the differences and we close our fists, that's the failure of the greatest potential of man, and that's his brain. And I think that we have enough intelligence to build a think tank to bridge the difference between nations rather than a Pentagon or a Bureau of Naval Operations, which I believe that if I had any top army men for just 3 weeks to give them bits they'd never heard of, I think I can distract their interest. I've done it in the Army before. The Army is a filthy organization comprised of men that are patriotic, simple. They need a great deal of information, because the real love of the continental United States is not to build super shiny arms, but to bridge the difference between nations, to build a world in which the end of armaments occur. This is the thing I'm talking about. It's not your fault, sir.
You think Woodrow Wilson was a bad man, or...
No, a nice guy, but simple.
It's out of war, you know.
Yeah, he was a nice guy, but simple.
Simple-minded.
Yes, not enough information. That's not a bad thing.
Not a Princeton University.
Yeah, he still was simple, so was Princeton. Princeton doesn't go into social engineering. It doesn't go into the human use of human beings. It doesn't teach students how to relate with other people and how to find meaning in their own life.
Do you like Ayn Rand?
No, she's a self-centered type of philosophy in which people who believe in, you know, get out there, do it yourself, a strong emphasis on the individual.
Selfishness.
I would say that it's centeredness, which I'd be afraid of. That kind of philosophy would generate tremendous fear in me, of my fellow man.
Does Harvard do it?
Harvard?
Yep.
Not a university in the country, sir. They're all part of the system.
They're the same as Princeton?
Yes, they are.
I'm happy to know that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, let me get in some more calls. Hello.
Hello?
Yes.
Mr. Fresco?
Yes.
Am I on?
Yes.
What is your political and religious belief?
Well, I don't have any political beliefs, but I'd like to see a scientifically oriented world, and I believe if you want a better world, you have to get up off your butt and make it better.
And he's an atheist religiously.
He's an atheist?
Yes.
Thank God.
This is WIOD, last call. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.